Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again. We have the reference picture ready, which is one I took. You know, one of those moments when you're out walking, you have your camera, the sun shines perfectly, everything just works perfect. I had one of those moments and captured this. Really, really happy. Because I really wanted to do something a little bit more special, a little bit more more exciting. I'm always looking to paint something exciting, so this excited me. And what I did, it's got a piece of chalk on this old canvas that I primed with some black gesso, and I've sketched the character and the archway and just used a bit of chalk to get the lights in. So if you're looking for a quick way to get a painting started, a stick of chalk will get you started for sure. And the great thing about chalk, as you probably know, is you just spit it on your finger and you can wipe it away. Oh, how delightful. How very British. So, we have our palette, a selection of colours. I've just thrown all sorts on. I don't really know what I'm going to need. I've got an idea. I'm going to change some things very slightly as well, because the photo is a bit blown out, and the background, I feel the sky could get a little bit of light blue in there. But anyway, that's why we have the ultramarine blue. Ultramarine blue, burnt umber, chrome yellow, titanium white. Got a couple of cadmium reds, the cadmium red deep, cadmium red light, viridian green and sap green. And my finger is dirty because I had to wash my brushes. The problem when you don't paint with oils on a regular basis, I have the horrible thing of washing brushes, which I really, really don't like doing. I'm one of those painters that doesn't wash brushes. I dip it in a bit of oil and oil of cloves, and then I just leave it and then use it again and again and again. I wish I could have done that, but I couldn't, because I haven't painted in a couple of weeks, which is depressing. It's a funny thing, actually. I keep myself in the game, so to speak, because if I don't paint, I draw, and if I don't draw, I'll sketch on the computer, or I will try my hand at other materials, but I never not do some form of art. It's all the same as well, really. Computer art, painting, drawing, all helps. I'm always trying to work out systems to make my own work a bit easier. Painting it, it's quite a hard thing, isn't it? And the more you do it, the more, for some reason, in your head you start going, well, I can do that. We can do something a bit harder. Let's do something a bit harder. And then you start giving yourself challenges and stuff, and you don't even realise that before you know it, you've got a load of paintings you need to do. And you're like, oh, no. Promised this painting and this painting. Now I'd have to really go for it. Oh, that keeps me motivated. Right, I'm going to start just wiping the brushes dry. I did a bit of vigorous cleaning on these brushes. I had to use paint thinner because I wanted them dry, cleaned quick. And then I used fairy liquid afterwards. And then give them a good wash. Not perfectly clean, but they're pretty much there. Anyway, let's put in some light blue in places. I think that's what I'm going to start with. We don't need to draw them background trees. There's some background trees we haven't drawn in. Some white and blue. Titanium white. Blue. Yeah, I've been messing on the computer designing a painting idea. I want to design a really good painting idea and then print it out and paint it. I've actually done one before. Buildings. Which I really need to see what that looks like printed out, actually. Right, let's put some sky in here. I'm going to about there. That goes down and that goes there. Got my reference picture to the side of me so I can quick glance at it. Like you can see on there, it's just blown out white, which, you know, might work, might not. But I know when my eyes didn't see it like that, and it wouldn't see it like that, so for me, I'm going to go with this light blue. So it's quite a nice day, actually, the day that I took this picture. Fun day. Nice walk. Sun was shining. Good day. The sun has been shining a lot recently. That's why my face is a bit redder. reddish brown. I've been catching some sunshine. I hope everybody is coping okay in the lockdown. It's been a bit of a challenge, hasn't it? A bit of a tiring period, especially people that have carried on working. I mean, it's hard for everybody, but I had to carry on working. At first, anyway, when it went crazy with shoppers, so I work in a retail environment. Shoppers were going crazy, buying everything up. Never seen it like that before. Except maybe, I mean, Christmas is usually bad, but I've never seen people panic buy so heavily before. To worry about that now. So I'm not working at the moment. I am taking some time off as holiday so I can relax, get the paints out and paint. Well, I can't visit anywhere. So just blocking this in. Need to get these background trees in. I want to keep the light as well, though. Might as well use this same brush. Put a bit of red in it. Some green, some sap green. Oh, there's blue on the slide. It's on the slide. I'll slide it back. So if your blue slides down, just slide it back up. It's homemade paint, you see. That one is. That's why it's on the slide. this raw sienna. I wonder what it was. I needed either yellow oak or raw sienna. Either would do me. So I'm going to throw in some of that into this colour. That's nicer. You know when you accidentally mix a colour? It's gotten happened. I've accidentally mixed this colour almost perfectly, look. That happens to me. I start mixing something and then I end up mixing something else. So, I think we have a tiny bit of red extra. Yeah, we've got this exact, so we might as well put it in. This is my philosophy on it. If I accidentally mix it, we might as well use it. So I've got my highlights locked in already, which makes this a bit easier. So I can see where the whiter bits are. And this goes around here. So that's worked out quite nice. Beautiful. There's a bit here, it's got a bit more blue in it. So, just pick up a bit of blue. Nice and easy, eh? Nice and easy. Okay, so that's got that nicely done. Happy with that. it's got quite a big chunk done already. And there's a bit of a lighter version of this colour on this side. Now that's in. Amazing how that works out. I could have pretended I meant to do that, but yeah, best to be honest. So I want some tree colour in here. There is actually some chimneys, but I don't think I'll put them in. I need to make this prominent there. I need some definite separation there. Might go into a... Gonna pick up some of the cad yellow just to throw that in. Mainly I needed a separator. throw in some brown as well. Here we go. Just break that up with different shades of green and brown. So that's good for that. Now I might quite nice if I can block in this tree here. Always thinking of similar colours as well, because I've done this. Got this is only a touch darker. Just to show you, a bit of blue, a bit of sap green, a bit of the brown. Almost got this colour here. So I'm getting that in while I can go a bit darker. Could do with another brush. Ultramarine blue is sliding a bit too much for me. There we go, use the knife just to move it. Right, let's put in. Oh, yeah, we need the dark. I'm going to get some of the blue and the brown. Blue and brown. As it was cold, I'm going to put some cold blue. It's more to the blue side to get that coldness. Because it were freezing. When the sun went, anyway. It's nice when the sun was out. So I'm going to do this the best I can, doing painting as much as I can really while it's still wet. There's some hints of brown in that colour. Just going to pick up some brown. Okie dokie. So I'll do for now. So just sit back and have a look at that as it is. I think I might block this bit in now. So I'll just wipe my brush. So I'll get some Viridian Green in with a sap green, just to boost it a bit. And blue. Almost there, it wants to be a little lighter. I'll probably do it. Just plonked a tiny bit of the yellow in there as well. Just to make it what I think is closer. See that quick move of the finger? Make all the difference for this painting. Painting, sometimes a finger is the most powerful painter's tool. I think it is anyway. And looking at the pattern, looking at this pattern, thinking about how I can get it done quick. What I'm thinking is, if I lighten this colour a bit, move it across. That's more of that colour. Slightly too light. It went from light to dark to light to dark. So I'll throw a bit of red in it because I made it too cool. I always think cool, warm, warm, cool. That's what I might do. Scrub this paint on. Not worrying too much. So we've got this light area here that we put in for ourselves so we can see. It's quite a nice warm bit here. A bit of yellow and red. Throw that in there. Should really hold back on stuff like that, but you see it and you think, oh, that looks good. it back again. Grabbing some yellow and red. I'm thinking with that, I've got this colour here-ish. And we can put a little bit of that in here. Just the paint on the side of the canvas then. Shoop. Go on that. Okay. Some areas. It's quite dark there. It's a setback, but it's quite warm. Same with that. Nicely blocked in. I'm going to get some this soil colour which to me is a ultramarine blue and burnt umber. So your ultramarine blue and burnt umber, you can make all kinds of shades and then you add the white. You've got all sorts, just with them two colours. Just with them two, it's amazing. I'm just scrubbing that in. Goes kind of warm, doesn't it? Goes warm, so I've got this warm area. Yeah, I've got this real warm there. Got a few bits we need to work on in here still, but I like to build the painting up. I'm sure you've, if it's your first time watching this, and you're wondering, what's going on? Why are you just blobbing paint here and there and not finishing it? It's because I like to build things up. I like to block it all in, and then build it up on top, kind of working that whole painting together. So I need quite a warmish green for this side. look on this, it's kind of, because the sun's on it, it's quite warm. I mean, the dark bit is quite warm. So we can put that in. So I can pick up a bit of the old cad yellow and red. I'm blocking this in now. I'll take it to about there. Got a bit warmer, lighter, just for this, some of these areas around here. I'll just put a few in. We need to work on them as well. A bit warmer there. Okay, we'll leave it at that. Now, we could paint all this in. I think I will. Got this tree that's sort of here. In a dark colour, there's one over this side which has got more of a blue into it, so I'll put some ultramarine blue in there. And there's that tree, which is a lot lighter. Put a little bit of iridium green in it. Okay, and then we've got this tree here. Darker here. There we go. Bit more to the cold. Something like that. Then, do we need all those? Got that, couple of poles. Don't really think I want them. Nah, I don't think I'll put those poles in there. I'll leave them out. We don't need them. Okay. Let's sit back. Yeah, let's not bother with those. Pick up some colour and... there. Okay, we'll go with that. That's a bit cleaner. I do prefer that. So just to combo things a bit. I need a bit of the browns that's in there. Put a little bit of that in here. Put a tree there and just go over. Go over that. Right. Just going to wipe my fingers a second before we do the next bit. I think the next bit will. Start putting in the strong light that's on the arch. The strong light we'll put in. And then we've got all this shadow, all this dark area. It's all like the shadow from the trees from behind us. It's going to hit that. It's quite warm, isn't it? Really warm sun. So, I think I'll wipe my brush. I'm still using the same brush. So, I'm going to go with this yellow, this white, so this is a good starting point. It is in need of some of this greeny browny colour. I get a bit of red as well. That's quite nice. This is actually a really close colour. Which might work quite well because it's got a the grain in the rock has got this colour in it, but there is changes, but let's not worry. Let's block things in while we're blocking things in. What I could do if it's blocking in the this background area. Sort of a greenish. There's these warm areas on this bush as well. A bit of that, a bit of dark. Sorry, I'm just painting away here. I threw in a bit of dark and a little bit of light and just a little, I chuck a bit of yellow in it. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. Let's see what happens. Okay. So let's get back to this. Let's block this in. Oops. Don't want that. Hopefully we can get rid of it. This is actually further up. That should be there. See how things become a little bit on the what's the word? Instinctively, you start painting instinctively, and I often forget to even talk about it because you get so wrapped up in it. So connected into the painting, you forget what you're doing. Well, you don't forget. You don't forget what you're doing. You just do it and you just dive into the painting, painting away, and you forget to talk about it. I think teaching painting is a really challenging thing, isn't it? I mean, I can't say this is exactly teaching, because it's not really, is it? It's me painting, and you might pick something up, it might help you out, you might not. When I first started this channel, I was excited about learning to paint. And I just found it really exciting, and I wanted to make videos because I was excited. I thought, oh, maybe someone else might learn something. And that's still the case. I still think someone might learn something. Might learn something and improve their painting. And that's good. A little inspiration. Lacking these colours, I'm really liking them, the changes of them. It's fun to paint them as well, fun to paint these different changes. Okay, try not to get too bogged down. Which is easy said. Easier said than done. Because when you get going, like me now, loving it, having fun, throwing in colour. Darting around, looking at colours that's not. Grays. Need a light green for that area, so we'll keep blocking in. Tell myself again to stop. Stop getting carried away. It's blocking this area. Shape a little bit there. It's here. See, I'm glad I did this chalk bit because it does help me a lot. In that light. Just noticed I've painted in the dark there. Didn't mean to do that. I just grabbed a bit of green there because I noticed it's a bit greener. I want to lose my warmth though. Bit of a changing. Oh. That's a bit too red. Just sit back, have a look at that. It's looking pretty good. Could do with a bit of the dancing around a bit on my palette trying to make this colour. It's sort of a lavendery greeny colour. It's a terrible explanation of the colour, but it's the closest I can think of is what it is. Okay, we've got, we're starting to build up a sense We're getting there. Battle on. Keep moving. We need now. Really want this shadow colour back. So I'm gonna go into this. Notice my palette is a right mess now. See why I call it a paint through rather than a lesson, because it's just madness on this palette. Madness. We want the dark back, but it's still warm, so if I go in here. Red and green, it dulls the green, but warms it, and we get like almost the colour we're after, so that's alright. Almost. Gets a heck of a lot darker as it goes down, I've noticed. Like down here. The bottom part. There's the bottom part. So now I need a bluey grey colour. Oh no, I haven't done this bit yet. Really cool look for this. We need to lighten these bits, but I'll do that in a minute. Let's get this area done. Okay. that's not too bad so far. That's not too bad. There's under the arch I need to darken a little bit. A little blue and brown. So that should be going up. No, it should be going. Should be like that. Kind of messes with your head a little bit because of the way the light is hitting this in a. In a very strange way. I think that'll do. So okay, we've got some nice lights. Greens in here as well that we need to put in. Anyway, let's not get carried away. Let's keep blocking in. Keep blocking in. Let's get the there's a warm ground. Using some of that. A bit of light, we can get this in. This is actually me there. This is the bit of a shadow of me taking the photo. How to get a self-portrait of yourself in a shadow portrait. Light in there. It's interesting how all this light works, isn't it? And of course, it's going all the way up there. Let's just sit back and look at that. Yeah. Just soften that a bit. Okay. Yeah, quite like that. That's blocking nicely. Now we need to do this colour here. It's kind of a... I think it's sort of a pretty red actually. Yeah, grab some blue and red, throw in some white. I'm almost. Yeah, that's about right. There's some minor changes in the colour, but you want this. You want this colour because this is going to make your warms warmer. I think it's interesting how blue it is as it goes through to here. cool me down. That. There's darker areas. Like this step here. Step down here. So I had a bit of a break and I'm back looking at the painting. Quite happy with what's gone on actually with the picture. It's looking pretty good. There's some areas that I need to improve on, little bits here and there. I need to paint the character in as well. Probably a good idea to do that now, and then we've got the whole painting done. So, need to use a smallish brush because I don't want to watch this up. So I want a bit of brown. So I'll block it in best we can. Everything that we make on this palette is green. You want some sort of a brown colour, just to block this in. Goes here. It's red. So this is the cadmium red deep. Probably could use a bigger brush than this. This brush is pathetic. Right, let's get a bigger brush because that was ridiculous. That brush, just some rubbish. can do much better with a bit bigger brush. See, I can blame my tools because I was right. They say a bad workman can't blame their tools, but you know. No, only a bad workman blames their tools, but when the tools are rubbish, then you can blame them, so. So let's get this red in there. You have to have something to blame, don't you? There we go. It's a nice red. That I like. The good thing about using a bigger brush, you get it on quicker. Gets a bit painting done quicker. Brilliant. So I need a bit of blue. Blue and red. That's almost right for the trousers colour. Girls running away. Well, not running away, running under there. Running under there. Away from the camera, I suppose. Go a bit darker for this bit here. I can always throw a little bit of the old blue in it or something. Need to go a little bit darker as well, actually. We need a bit of the blue and brown. The Wellingtons. Probably need to go back to the other brush. This bit. Let's see. Get away with it. I'm trying to keep this quite impressionistic in a sense as well. Hey, that works quite nice. I might get a little bit of that red and the blue and just tidy this up a little bit here. get a bit of light on the head. On the hair. I want to line up some of this as well. Just sort of sitting back, having a look, see if it's bright enough. Feel it was, so got a bit brighter there. Need a bit of a pink for the hand as well. A bit of light on one side there. Just a little bit of light. There we go, I won't do too much on that. A little bit of light here on the leg. Into the light blue, I'll just get something on that. Indication of the shoe there.
Right.
No. This doesn't look right there. That's not too bad here. Nice brown colour. To get this bit there. Sit back, have a look. What I need is a really dark splodge to get that splodge that goes like that. The light that just hits the top. There we are, that's the indication. That'll do. We'll keep moving. Keep moving. Quite like that, actually. Got a nice movement going on there. Of course, could always be improved. What I would do if I wanted to try and improve it is get the old brush out again after it's dried a bit. Right, let's look at the whole picture now. I want to do some of these few leaves. few leaves on the ground over here. Lighter than this. This is a bit too dark. That's better. Now I can put my leaves back in. Just a few here and there. Okay, I'll do this. Some different shades of colour, just put them in. We're not going to do every brick. Not for this one anyway. I mean you can do that. I'm just going for the whole impression on this one really, because I don't think I want this video to go on for 2 days. 2 days non-stop, I mean. Me painting and painting. So a little bit of yellow, a little bit of the Viridian green. Get a nice colour. We can use for these little spots, it's almost like algae on the rock. Get some of that in places. Some of it's a bit warmer than others, so just pick up a little bit of the yellow. Look, there's some nice yellow bits there. Quite like that red in there, so I'm going to leave that. Bit of that dark and Throwing a bit of red in my colour there. A bit of red in the dark. But you know, if you want to, you could put in every roll. Dark on this side. That bit should be a bit lighter there. Some really light bits in places. I'll start working on that. I don't want to use this tiny brush. I keep getting this tiny brush in my hand. I don't want to use that one. I'll go for this one. It's quite as tiny. And I can work on things. Those rock shapes and trying to do the whole painting in one sitting, so I don't want to be laying around too much. I'm sure there's plenty of you thinking, well, it's hard to know when to stop when you're painting. When do you stop? If you notice, what I'm doing is trying to use the brush strokes to create shapes. Like in this bit, like I know that there's. I need to create that illusion of that. And some areas. I don't mind that. trying to keep things flowing. So I'm trying to keep this, keep it flowing, and there's areas where there needs to be a bit more drama within the colour. I'm going to use light pressure in these areas. Too bright there, because we want to keep the brightness where we need it. Of course, where we need it is over here. Some sort of a bit of a bush there. Random things. Okay. Bit of grass there. There's a bit of light on the grass there. Sort of matches up with that light. That's where that light is. Right, now I want sort of a grey. Well, I could do with just doing this. too many. That's better. It's always easy to do too much. I don't know why. A bit of red. Better, I prefer that. Alright, let's carry on. I might put a line there just to just kind of emphasizes it a bit. Tempted to emphasize this as well. Good idea, actually. Now I'll do this. Leaves over here. There, I think. Kind of want a bit more. A little more, isn't it? A little more detail, but not too much. Now I want to remove some of the blue. Grey. Sort of a greyish, bluish. Yeah, sort of this. Just to get rid of some of the harsher blues. Does work. There's something else I could do with. A bit of a separator. Yeah, I quite like that. It's quite a nice little painting. It's not too detailed. That's always a bit of a trick. When you want it to be painterly, it's quite hard to prevent detail. Try not to overdo, as I need to tell myself. Try not to overdo. I think that'll do. I think we'll call that a bit of a line there, just but yeah, I really like that actually. That's come out quite nice. Pretty happy with that. It's got a still got the looseness as if I'm painting in there almost. It's still got that freshness. The movement's quite good. That's probably a little bit too bright. Might dull that a little bit. That shoe. Yeah, pretty happy with that. That's got a nice look to it. I think we need probably a bit of light that goes along there. Using some of the brightest white. in areas specifically around our character. So sneaky, isn't it? Because that way you're gonna the eye of the viewer is gonna go straight for the character. A little bit of blue on there now. It's quite nice. I'm quite happy with that now. Yeah, pretty happy with that. Don't think we need any more detail. Maybe there's a gives it a bit more on the inside there. Bit of light probably along here. Yeah. I think that'll do. Pretty happy with that. Just get rid of that bit there. Like I said, you could keep going. You could do all sorts. I think that'll do for me. Too many marks and then mess it up, so we'll probably call that now. Yeah, I'll call that one finished. I really like it actually. I do really like it. I enjoyed painting it, but I really like the painting as well. Just going to make this a bit more transparent. It's a bit too too solid. Same there, just so you can see in amongst the dark bit. I want it to be I'll do. Right, brush goes down. Or do I put a few of those branches? I've got time. I'm running out of time, so I'll just put a few of these little branches in here. even one that comes all the way across like that. I think that'll do. I think we'll call it there. I quite like that. Yeah, really happy with that. Oh, I'll tell you what. Just change the top of the head bit to a bit darker. Okay. Right. We'll keep going forever, so we better stop. let's put a little bit of a signature. See, it is tricky because sometimes you do keep going forever and then you might do something that ruins the whole thing. And that does happen. It's happened for me anyway. You just keep painting and painting and painting, and then what do? You paint too many things and then the whole thing ends up ruined. It does. It does happen, unfortunately. Overpainting it. Let's put a little JB here. So I'm not using any mediums. So when I learned the style of painting, I didn't need any mediums. I was like, oh, this is brilliant. The only thing I really use is if I'm doing multiple layers and letting it dry, then that's when I'll use a tiny drop of linseed oil. And other than that, I don't need them. Yeah, so we'll call this one finished. Finished. I'm just looking at areas that might need cleaning up. I think we're pretty happy there. I think we're pretty happy. Need to remember to get these bright, strong areas around the main character, remember. Right, we'll call that one finished. So thanks very much for watching this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Let me know by giving it a like, and then the more likes I get, the more likes I get. Now, the more likes I get, the higher this video goes up in the YouTube system, so more people will watch it, which helps the channel grow, and helps people that might want to learn something, or inspire somebody. I could soften some of these, or not, depending on what you want to do, but I think I'll leave it there. Hold myself back and say thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you at another one. Cheers, bye.